The order was founded in, or got the official approval from the papal bull, signed on the 22nd of December 1216. And that's how we are now celebrating the 800th year of the order. Well, the school opened its doors to students in on the 10th of February 1953. At the time, there were 6 Dominicans on the staff, 5 teaching Dominicans and 1 assisting in the house. The population, the school population of students was approximately 45 to 50. I arrived in on the 1st of March 1960. So that'll be around about 56 years almost at this stage. When I started at Blackfriars, it was still very much in its early times. We had one main building, which is still standing today. We had another building which was built by one of the priests. He was an architect, surveyor, builder, etc. And he put up the science laboratories for the senior boys.
Brother Brendan has been here for a significant period assisting and making sure the school keeps operating and going in the direction. As a student with the Dominican Order, particularly here in Australia, we all knew the Blackfriars was one of the works of the Order. Coming over here, I can see the very much benefit that Blackfriars has for the Order and that the Order has in giving to Blackfriars. Now the Order has a different understanding of the four pillars because we live in community all together, and so where we talk about preaching as one of our pillars, the school has service. So the four pillars being prayer, study, community life and service for the school. And I see that as the foundation of the school from which everything should flow through. We live in a multicultural society, and I think the school reflects that. We have a vast diversity of cultures that come together at school. And though we have less than 50% who are Catholic in the school, I think the four pillars creates a foundation for the school that any culture and any faith can look at and see as something worthwhile with which to develop with. Prayer, I see, is the major of the pillars. And I don't want to make them any different size, but it is our contemplation and relationship with God that then leads to how we interact with our neighbour. And here, that flows into our community. So because of our relationship with God, we want to know more about God. And that's where our study is. And that's why it's so significant that we have St. Albert the Great, one of the first Dominicans, who is said to have known and read every book that had been written in that time. So his desire to know more about creation is a desire to know more about God. And I see it that our relationship with God impels us to be able to teach the students we have here to know more about creation, because that helps them more about God and then helps them to live within society and help those people around them. So the basis of all we do is based on our relationship with God.
Thank you.
The order was founded in, or got the official approval from the papal bull, signed on the 22nd of December 1216. And that's how we are now celebrating the 800th year of the order. Well, the school opened its doors to students in on the 10th of February 1953. At the time, there were 6 Dominicans on the staff, 5 teaching Dominicans and 1 assisting in the house. The population, the school population of students was approximately 45 to 50. I arrived in on the 1st of March 1960, so that'll be around about 56 years almost at this stage. When I started at Blackfriars, it was still very much in its early times. We had 1 main building, which is still standing today. We had another building which was built by one of the priests. He was an architect, surveyor, builder, etc. And he put up the science laboratories for the senior boys.
Brother Brendan has been here for a significant period assisting and making sure the school keeps operating and going in the direction. As a student with the Dominican Order, particularly here in Australia, we all knew the Blackfriars was one of the works of the Order. Coming over here, I can see the very much benefit that Blackfriars has for the Order and that the Order has in giving to Blackfriars. Now, the Order has a different understanding of the four pillars because we live in community all together. And so where we talk about preaching as one of our pillars, the school has service. So the four pillars being prayer, study, community life, and service for the school. And I see that as the foundation of the school from which everything should flow through. We live in a multicultural society, and I think the school reflects that. We have a vast diversity of cultures that come together at school. And though we have less than 50% who are Catholic in the school, I think the four pillars creates a foundation for the school that any culture and any faith can look at and see as something worthwhile with which to develop with. Prayer, I see, is the major of the pillars. And I don't want to make them any different size, but it is our contemplation and relationship with God that then leads to how we interact with our neighbour. And here, that flows into our community. So because of our relationship with God, we want to know more about God. And that's where our study is. And that's why it's so significant that we have St. Albert the Great, one of the first Dominicans, who is said to have known and read every book that had been written in that time. So his desire to know more about creation was a desire to know more about God. And I see it that our relationship with God impels us to be able to teach the students we have here to know more about creation, because that helps them more about God and then helps them to live within the society and help those people around them. So the basis of all we do is based on our relationship with God.
Thank you. Thank you.